Hey everybody and welcome back to another Darkfall tutorial. So today we're going to be fixing lens distortion, as you can see in the example here. So as you can see, I'm using Blender version 2.8. If you've not upgraded to 2.8, I'll throw a link in the description. Go ahead and download that now. So for this project, I'm going to use the VFX workstation. So go ahead and click that. Now we don't need these two windows, so I'm going to right click here and then join this area. I'm also going to right click here and join the area again. So now I can go ahead and load up our movie clip. So this is the clip I'm using, and I'll throw a link in the description if you want to use it too. But the first thing we notice is that the colors have changed, and that's because it's now using Filmic. So what we need to do is go over here to render, then scroll all the way down to color management, and then we can change this from Filmic back to standard. So now we have this, let's go ahead and set the scene frames. If you click this, it will change the timeline to be the length of your movie clip. Then we can go ahead and prefetch. So click this button here and this bar will fill up all the way. If it doesn't fill up all the way, you will need to go to edit, then to preferences, and then go to system, and then just increase the memory cache limit. Then you can come back and prefetch this and it'll fill up all the way. So if we play through this clip, we can see we have this group of people, but there's a lot of lens distortion or fisheye or whatever you want to call it. So what we're going to do is just fix that up so it looks a lot better. So for this, it's pretty simple. All we need to do is go over here to track, then go down to where it says lens, and we have these options here. Now, if you've done any kind of motion tracking in the past, you're probably already aware what these do. So if you move these values, the edges will distort and it should correct the lens distortion. And we don't actually see anything right now, so let's go over here to clip display. And then this option here, render undistorted, just click this. And then now we can see it as a preview. So you just want to drag these values and kind of straighten these edges. So just keep playing around with these until you get something that looks good. If we play through a bit more. So as we can see here, there's quite a bit more distortion. So let's try and fix that. So already it looks a lot better. I mean, if we turn this on and off, we can see it's definitely an improvement. I mean, if you just watch these two people here, we can see right now they look part of the group, but if we turn this off, they kind of look a bit further away from these because of the distortion. So it's definitely an improvement to fix this distortion. So when you're happy with this, we need to go ahead and jump to the compositing. Then let's go ahead and use nodes. Then we want to select this render layers here, and then you can either press X and delete it, or you can hold shift and press S. And then we can switch the type. So let's go ahead and change this to a movie clip. And then if we select this movie clip icon, change this to cliff. Now if we hold Control Shift and left click on this node, we can see a preview. And let's just make this a bit smaller. So all we really need to do is add one node. If we Shift A, go to distort, and then add in a movie distortion. Just drop this in. Connect this up to the viewer as well. Then click the movie clip icon, select the movie clip, and there we go. It's really that easy. We can see we have that lens distortion has been fixed. And again, if we select this and press M to mute it, we can see the difference. Looks a lot better. I mean, you can spend a bit more time and make it look even better than that. So it only takes one node to fix the lens distortion. Now we have this, we can go ahead and render it out. The first thing we want to do is go to output. And then we want to make sure that the video resolution is the same as the movie clip that we're using. And if you don't remember the video resolution, what you can do is go to motion tracking, go back to footage here, and then you can see exactly what the resolution is. So what I need to do is just go ahead and change this. And there we go. So now the resolution is correct. Make sure this percentage slider is at 100. You also want to make sure you remember where you saved this to. So make sure you save the output. And then down to file format, we want to change this from PNG to an ffmpeg video. Then go to encoding and choose the encoding that you want. I'm going to use H.264 in MP4 format. And then once you're done with the settings, go over to render. And you can either click render animation or use the shortcut, which is Control F12. But go ahead and render it out. So hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, be sure to give this a like. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.